Gude, recently I got pointed to the videos of Tyler DeWitt. I signed up for the challenge to recreate his approach. In this video, I will show you how to do it. First, we notice two cameras, given that Tyler is seen and his hands appear synchronously on screen. The educator himself is in front of a black background. That is the reason why he's blending in so seamlessly. The main screen is used to move pre-organized papers and information. Notice how this blends together once again. It looks like one coherent layer. The overall perspective is done by using an overhead camera. We will recreate that in a moment. The last element to the composition is the gallery in the bottom. Same style and font than before, but what you really see is a pre-organized picture gallery. And now I hand over to the breakdown. Well, we execute the exact same steps. Camera one pointing at me, and I'm in front of a unicolor or very equally colored background so that we don't have any distraction whatsoever. And I'm wearing something that is easily recognized in front of that unicolored background. Then we have setup number two, in which I just roll my pre-organized elements. And this kind of orchestration, this kind of what steps to do next will be, I think, the biggest issue, because you have to talk, you have to show your hands, you have to orchestrate all at the same time while thinking what's coming next, so to speak. This will be, beside of the overcam angle, the biggest issue, in my opinion. Down there, we have some gallery, some sliding image gallery. I just pumped in some debug or example posts. You could put in a schedule, a link, an LMS, your email address or contacts, something like that. But be aware, you have to stand still pretty much and you'd rather move around with your hands. It's like, it feels a little bit like DJing, if I'm really honest. Down there at the corner, you might put in the topic or the general broadest grand scheme of things, if you will. And now let's have a look on the outer perspective. Camera one, camera two, and the microphone is just out of shot. And you can see you need quite a lot of space and you need equal lighting. I have one lighting source coming from the top. It could be thinkable that you have a different lighting source, but you want to have equals or no shadows whatsoever in this picture. So what lecture content is this actually good for? In my opinion, whenever you have a composition of elements that could be rearranged, maybe we have a logic introduction lesson and you say, okay, argument one and two are a parent component of argument number three. Four, six, and five, maybe just an alignment argument. Maybe you have an interwoven argument of style. So this whole composition would actually change. Another huge advantage is if you want to showcase different examples. And then for different examples, you highlight what is actually on the tableau, you quickly exchange it, and your students will know what kind of information correlates to that specific example when they see it. And with a few cuts, you can simply readjust what you just said and jump between examples. So whenever you have a composition that has not only one logic order, but more, or could be reorientated, then that whole DJing or moving around things really comes in clutch. Another huge advantage is showing tangible things. The overhead cam is always a good usage for that. I, for instance, have a breakout board with me and some ESP8266. And instead of showing you the teeny tiny, I could say, okay, we have some digital inputs 1 to 8 over here. You wouldn't able to see the general input and outputs on the breadboard itself. You have one analog output. We could talk about the ground. Maybe I pull up some batteries and we actually use that whole electrical circuit. Things like that are really good to showcase. And as a last and third one, you can obviously write as you speak to not only say, okay, those two composites or elements do not work together, but at the same time, and that's I think why Tyler used it, especially in chemistry, have some reactions or something that is going on between two elements or some artifacts. And you could use that canvas in a more passive way or in a more active way. That's for the breakdown, back to the studio. So to sum that up, you will need proper preparation for this scene, especially when it comes to the paper props and the orchestration of your movements. The more videos you create in this style, the more likely it is that you have a core set of foiled or wrapped sheets or some sort of core papers, if you will. Hardware-wise, the overhead camera will be the most challenging part. You either need a tripod with some counterweight or a sturdy boom stand. Two cameras are required, which makes it rather a semi-permanent setup. Use it for several videos, otherwise I cannot justify the rather equipment-heavy setup. In one of his comments, Tyler specifies that he combines and edits the video afterwards. I recreated the composition in OBS by using the video feeds directly from the cameras, which has the advantage of editing less footage afterwards, but comes with a downside of having one video mix that cannot be deconstructed easily again. Overall, it's a very nice setup and honestly so much ahead of its time, given that Tyler established that scene almost 10 years ago. Happy teaching and Gude out from my side.